This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to find a center of rotation and the angle of rotation. So I've got this orange quadrilateral, and I've labeled it A, B, C, D. And its image has been rotated through some angle over to where the green quadrilateral is. I've labeled that A prime, B prime, C prime, and D prime, so we can see the corresponding angles. The first step in finding the center of rotation is going to be to connect two pairs of corresponding points with a straight edge. So I'm going to connect point A and point A prime, and then I'll also connect point B and point B prime. And now what I want to do is use a compass to find the perpendicular bisector for each of those lines that I've just drawn. So I'll place the compass point at point A and draw some arcs. And then I'll place it at point A prime and draw two more arcs that intersect the first ones I've drawn. And I'll switch to a black marker so we can see what I've got. I'm going to connect those points of intersection, and the line that I get is a perpendicular bisector for line segment A, A prime. And now I'm going to do the same process for the other line, B, B prime. So I'll place the compass point at B prime, and once again draw some arcs, and then move the compass point to B and intersect those arcs with two more arcs. And I'll take the places where those arcs intersected, connect them, and now I've got a second perpendicular bisector. That's the perpendicular bisector to line or line segment B, B prime. And the place where those two bisectors intersect each other is the center of rotation. Okay, so once again, what I did was I connected two pairs of corresponding points. Then I found the perpendicular bisectors for the line segments that I'd made by connecting those points. The place where the perpendicular bisectors intersect each other is the center of rotation. Now, I'm going to clean up some of these extra lines that I don't need and show how to find the angle of rotation. Okay, so that's a little bit neater. To find the angle of rotation, I'm going to draw a line from the center of rotation to one of the points on my original image. So I'm going to connect the center of rotation with point A. Now, when that image rotated, it rotated fixed at the center of rotation through an angle so that that line ended up connecting the center of rotation and A prime. So to find the angle of rotation, all I want to do is take a protractor and measure the angle. Okay, so the angle I get looks like 125 degrees. No, I'm sorry, that's 130 degrees. Okay, so the angle that that image rotated through was a 130 degree angle. Okay, so that's how to find the center of rotation and then the angle of rotation. Take care. I'll see you next time.